Your mind is extremely powerful, and it is so vital that your thoughts are on the right things during your journey back to health, and or just in your journey throughout life, that you have to have your mind in the right place. You have to have your mind filled with the right thoughts. And if it's not, it's going to make you stuck. It's going to send you in the wrong direction. It's going to make things worse. And that's something I just wanted to remind you, because I have to remind myself that a lot. I have to remind myself that, you know what? On this journey to heal my body, I also have to look at the fact that because my body has been messed up, that has messed up my spirit, that's messed up my mind, my soul, like just like everything. And I can get stuck in the patterns that are going all along in my mind that are not going to allow me to heal my body. Now, so because when you go through something horrible and or like you catch a horrible sickness or something is going wrong in your body, or you've had emotional trauma or anything, whatever's gone wrong and that has made you not okay, whether it's physically or mentally, emotionally, spiritually, all of that stuff, on your road to recovery and road to healing and everything, if you do not if you're not really aware of what's going on in your mind, you can get stuck in your situation and never improve. You can get stuck in a place where you don't have the fight anymore. You can get stuck with the thought patterns that perpetuate sickness and that keep you sick. And so whether or not they caused you to be sick or not, it doesn't really matter, because once you're in a sick zone and your body is all messed up, your mind can actually keep you there by perpetuating just like the bad thoughts, which are very powerful, plus bad habits, bad things, choices, that kind of stuff. And you never really go anywhere because you're just stuck. Because you're just doing the same old all the time, and you don't even realize it. And so that's something that, like, as I feel that I'm on the verge of more and more healing. However, I can tell that my coping mechanisms, my thought patterns, my habits, my influences that I allow into my life, are holding me back. And so I've had to make this choice, and like, you know what? I've got to step outside of myself. So I recommend you every so often, like, completely step outside of yourself and like kind of look at your situation from an objective point of view. It's very difficult to do, but you can do it if you're thoughtful about it. You step out and you look at yourself and you look at your situation. You look at your influences, your habits, your coping things that you do, the people that you're around, even looking at your body from an outside point of view, like make, because you know, if you're not feeling good and all that stuff, you really aren't gonna look at yourself in pictures or videos or anything like that, because you don't even want to be a part of that. But it can be very eye-opening if you can look at yourself, photograph yourself, video yourself, look at yourself objectively, and start to like seek truth about yourself and about what's going on in your mind, what's going on in your habits and all that stuff. So like look at the influences that are coming into your mind. Like, what are you watching? What are you reading? What are the people that you're hanging out with? What is going on? What are the influences that are coming in that you're allowing into you? Are they healthy? Are they helpful? Are they sending you in the right direction? And if they're not, what can you change? How about your habits? Like the little things that you do throughout the day. Are they promoting health? Or are they promoting just kind of staying stuck? Or are they making you worse? Are you self-sabotaging? Oh my gosh. I don't know about you, but I'm a human being, and so I do stupid stuff all the time to like sabotage myself. And I'm like, why did I do that? That was so ridiculous. And you know, whether it's eating a food that makes me feel bad, or staying up way too late to put pressure on my body, or putting too much stress on myself to like get too many things done, and you know, it's like I'm sabotaging myself, or being a part of or watching something or reading something that I know brings me down? You know, all of these different things, you need to look at them and make sure that everything that's coming in and everything that you're doing is promoting you on your road to healing. And the road to healing is bumpy and strange and crazy and like a roller coaster. And so as things shift and turn and change, reevaluate, shift and change with it. Don't just stay stuck in the same old that you were doing. If you get a teeny tiny bit better, if you get a teeny tiny bit better, change, do something different so that you can continue to get a teeny tiny bit better. Don't just stay in the same thought patterns and same everyday like stuff. Change something, make it better. So that's my encouragement for you today is think happy, healthy thoughts. Make sure that your mind is envisioning you healthy. Make sure your mind is envisioning you better than today, tomorrow, and that every little inching your way there is positive because your mind is powerful and it will either perpetuate sickness or it will create health. And so don't get stuck in the mindset of sickness and the mindset of things are not okay when it possibly could improve and you could possibly get a little bit better. You could possibly make a change because you cannot completely heal if your mind is stuck thinking sick thoughts and keeping you stuck there. So my prayer and hope for you is today is better than yesterday and that you make tomorrow better than today by making sure that your mind is full of those positive thoughts that you need to continue to move forward. And so I will see you next time. If this video helped you or inspired you in any way, give it a thumbs up. Hit subscribe if you're brand new here and so that we can hang out again. And then also share this. If you know somebody who's stuck and needs some encouragement, send them this video so that they can continue to reevaluate their situation and move forward. So I love you guys. I'll see you later.